Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel MS School of English. In this video lecture, I am going to present before you a very wonderful poem written by one of the greatest poets from America. The name of the poem is The Road Not Taken, and it is written by Robert Frost. Robert Frost was born in America in 1874. However, his work was published in England before it was published in America. Anyhow, he became popular both in America and in England, and his greatness is that he was the only person to be given 4 Pulitzer Prizes for poetry. One remarkable point about Robert Frost's poetry is that it seems to be meaning one thing at the surface level. If we delve deep, we get an entirely different meaning. Let me read the poem first. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both and be one traveler. Long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Here, the narrator is going along a road, and the road is in a deep forest. Wood means forest. And as he comes to the end of the road is pronging into two. It is forking into two. It is dividing into two. That is, there's a Y junction. And now, the narrator has to take a decision as to whether to travel by the first way or the second way. And sorry, I could not travel both. It is not possible for him to take both ways, right? So he has to either go by the first way or the second way. And be one traveler, long I stood and looked down as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Now, he is alone. He does not have any company to discuss and take a decision as to whether to go by the first way or the second way. Being all alone, he ponders as to which way he should take. Long I stood and looked down as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. He checked the first way as far as he could. Then, took the other, just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. And after having a look at the first one, now he comes to the second one, and he looks at the second way, and both are almost like equal, and the second way is rougher than the first one because it was grassy and wanted wear. Wear means repair. Though as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. To some extent both of them are one and the same. Afterwards, the second one is more grassy than the first one, indicating that the first one might have been used by others, whereas the second one does not have any indication of having been used by other people. And both that morning equally lay in leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. Now the narrator is saying that on that particular morning he took that particular road, both these forks, both these divisions lay in leaves, covered with leaves. No step had trodden black. That is, they were covered with leaves and there was no indication of anybody having walked on those leaves. Otherwise, there might have been some kind of black marks, footprints. Oh, I kept the first for another day. And now, on impulse, he decides that the first one should be kept for another day. yet knowing how way leads to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. He is not sure where the second route would lead him to, but still he is dare enough to take the second route. Without having any understanding of the second route, he takes a risk to go by that particular route. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less travelled by, and that has made all the difference. And now, he is coming to the conclusion. He is saying that he was encountered with two ways. He was in a dilemma whether to take the first one or the second one. And he was bold enough, he was dare enough to take the one less travelled by. Generally, people go by the way which others have taken before them. But here, this man being an enterprising one, this man being a daring one, he takes up the challenge of travelling by the road less travelled by. And that has made all the difference. Friends, this particular thing appears to be a person's dilemma as he walks along the way. If we imply the same to our lives, if we apply the same to our careers, we will get to know that taking a measured risk and going by the way less travelled by takes us to success and accomplishment. So this is the moral of this particular poem. The poem advises us not to take the routine route that everybody takes. It asks us, it urges us to be a little enterprising, to take up challenges and to be ready to take risk so that we could take the risk of walking to the route which very few or none has taken before us, so that we could become the pioneers in that particular way of life. So this is the moral of this particular poem. Though the poem seems to be saying one thing, at a deeper level, it has got a philosophical meaning that we should be dare enough to take challenges and we should walk the way in which nobody else has walked earlier. Thanks for watching.